Okay, good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
How are you?
Good.
Well, I'm also very well. And your guide is going to take you around in the prison. Let me introduce myself. My name is Fox, S-P-A-R-K-S, Fox. I'm an ex-political prisoner. I spent 7 years here on probation. I was charged in 1983 and released in 1990. My charge was terrorism under Section 29. So don't be afraid, I'm not going to terrorize you.
Gentlemen, we are now in F section courtyard, where we used to eat and exercise. We were forced to squatter there to eat. Whether it's raining or not raining, and on our right hand side, we have a sport field. We used to play rugby and soccer there only on Sundays for 30 minutes. The other days we have to go and work there in lime and stone quarry. So let's proceed inside.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, so these are F section communal or general cells. So each cell was accommodating about 60 people. So this small room was used for dispensing some medication. The doctor only comes once a week during Wednesdays. So if you are sick on Thursday, you will face the consequences. Or rather, you have to wait the following Wednesday. So now let's proceed to this section to myself. Mind your step, please. So we are now in this section, one of the communal or general cells here on Promenade. And I spent most of my 7 years in prison. In this cell, we were forced to share that bathroom. Inside that bathroom, there are 3 showers and 2 toilets. We were forced to wake up early in the morning at 4 a.m. During those years, we had to wash thrice a week, during Mondays, Wednesdays, and Saturdays. The other 4 days, there was no water here on Brooklyn. And people like Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela spent 18 years here on Robben Island, sleeping on the floor using those 2 mats. So they were allowed to sleep with 1 blanket, even during the winter season. And during those years, there were no glasses inside those window frames. We were segregated here on Robland. The black political prisoners were allowed to wear the short sleeve shirts, short trousers, with no socks, no shoes, no jackets, even during the winter season. People like Nelson Koneketa Mandela spent 18 years here on Rockland. Is 2 by 3 meters square. Inside Mandela's cell, there is a bucket that was used by Nelson Mandela for 18 years here on Robben. Because there are no toilets, no taps, and no toilet papers inside their cells, they were forced to use those buckets to relieve themselves. And also inside Mandela's cell, there are 3 folded blankets as political prisoners. We were forced to fold our blankets the way they showed us. If you have folded your blankets in a different way, the authorities will lock you in solitary confinement. They will beat you using shambles, punches, whipping, and also kicking you. So Nelson Mandela spent only 18 years in that cell. After 18 years, he was deported to Paulsboro prison, where he spent 7 years. And after 7 years, he was deported to Victor Vesta prison, where he spent 2 days. And where he was released in 1990, 11th of February. So Nelson Mandela spent 27 years in prison. With no socks, no shoes, no jacket, and also no underwear. And we were segregated on diet scale. That was the diet scale that was given to us as political prisoners. So colored and Asian political prisoners on meal. They were given 6 ounces, which is 200 grams. And black political prisoners were given 12 ounces, which is 400 grams. But during my arrival, I was given another name. I myself was called 5683. And Nelson Koneketa Mandela was called 46664. And we were given a yellow card. On that yellow card, they will write your new name. That was the yellow card that was given to us as a political. There was no admission, no parole here on problems. And I myself, I was sentenced for 15 years. But because of the gradual release of political prisoners, I only spent 7 years. Because all political prisoners were released on 27th of April, 1991.